Welcome to the tutorials on the 3DS Max Retopology Modifier. Since its release, there have been ongoing updates improving features and performance. The most significant enhancement so far is the preprocess feature, which has fundamentally transformed the entire workflow. Let's explore it. If you add a Retopology modifier, there is the preprocess mesh checkbox, which is on by default. Let's compute with the default. 3 seconds. Let me turn off this modifier and add another one. Then, let's turn off the option and compute. Now, it took 12 seconds. With preprocessing enabled, we lost some details, but it was 4 times faster. Additionally, the preprocessed version has a more accurate shape around the ear. I'll open the output dropdown and select Remeshed Mesh. Look at all the same size triangles. Preprocessing or remeshing is the step that converts the mesh into these evenly distributed triangles. Then, the modifier retopologizes using this mesh. Using preprocessing is especially important when your target is significantly lower compared to the original mesh. Let me set the target to 500 for each case and compute again. You can clearly see which one is better. Also, look at the number of polygons of the unpreprocessed one. It has a lot more polygons than the target, while the preprocessed one is pretty close to the target. This happens because the target face count is not strictly enforced. Rather, it acts as a guideline. Reform can miss the mark when the target is much lower than the mesh detail. Therefore, turning on preprocessing helps ensure that the modifier produces a result close to the target. Here's an interesting workflow to consider. When you open the algorithm dropdown, you'll see that preprocess is one of the available options. This allows you to perform only the preprocess step independently of the target count. So, you can adjust the preprocess amount separately from the target count to balance detail and processing time. The model on the left was first preprocessed at 500,000 polygons, and then retopologized to 50,000 polygons, taking a total of 315 seconds. The model on the right was directly retopologized to 50,000 polygons with preprocessing, taking 47 seconds. While the two-step approach takes more time, it clearly preserves more details compared to the single-step method at a similar polygon count. Before moving to the next topic, I want to discuss a case that can cause retopology to fail. This is a scan of the head of Michelangelo's David, containing 1 million vertices and triangles. When I tried to retopologize it to 50,000, after almost 5 minutes, it failed. If you see the remeshed triangles, it means the retopology failed. Let me display the hard edges. Look at all those tiny hard edges. You might recall that the auto edge and smoothing group options were on by default. Since we asked the modifier to keep all those hard edges while retopologizing, it tried its best and gave up. Now, let me turn off the auto edge and compute. It works. Here's an important tip. When retopologizing any scanned or organic geometry, I recommend always adding a smooth modifier and setting all faces to 1ID first. You might ask why not just turn off the auto edge. Well, as you saw, without auto edge, all the smoothing groups are gone. So you will still need to add a smooth modifier afterward, anyway. Therefore, why not add below the retopology modifier? We will revisit this later again. But anytime you turn on auto edge, it is crucial to ensure the auto edge condition is reasonable. In my experience, this is the number one reason why retopology fails. Now let's check the opposite case. A low-res hard surface model with small details like these holes. Let's try with the default settings. The preprocessing on and auto edge with smoothing group. It failed, which isn't surprising. Look at the preprocessed mesh. The target count was certainly not enough to keep details around the edge of small holes, and the modifier lost the edges to constraint and failed. Try with a 10,000 target. It still fails. 15,000 worked, but the edge around the hole is still not great, and I'm not happy with the poly count either. It seems too many. So, the preprocess is certainly not working for this case. Let's try to turn off preprocess mesh. Set the target back to 5,000. Then, compute. Now we got something this time. But the quality is still not that great. Let's make it better. Turn off the Retopology modifier. Apply Edit Poly modifier under it and display hard edges. These green edges are the current constraint. Add Smooth modifier under Edit Poly and turn on Auto Smooth. Set threshold to 11.1. You can see every other edge for the side of holes and some edges for the curved portion are selected. Add another Retopology modifier. Compute. Okay, the area around the hole looks way better now. But I'm still not happy with this part. It's happening because there's a big empty spot in the source mesh, and the edge flow is really affecting the retopology process. We can make it better with a subdivide modifier. Turn off the last retopology modifier. Add a subdivide modifier change mode to adaptive. Set edge length to 10. I'll explain why I'm changing the mode later. Add retopology modifier. Turn off the preprocess and compute. Much better. But here and here could be better. Go back to Edit Poly and select the edges you want to keep. Then, press the hard button. This will make the selected edges as hard edges. Compute! You can see the new hard edges are preserved, and they are still hard edges. Add a smooth modifier to reset the hard edges. A light. That looks good. Let's compare how much it has improved from the initial version. Before we move on, let's quickly check something together. I retopologized the CAD parts using three different subdivide modifier setups. First, I use the default subdivide mode. You can see that the retopologized mesh follows the original mesh's edge flow. This took 10 seconds. Next, I tried adaptive mode. I switched to this earlier because it gives more evenly distributed triangles. This one took 8 seconds. Finally, I reduced the edge length to 5 for more subdivisions. Look around the holes. The edge distances were reduced, which gave us better topology. This took 11 seconds, but I think the extra 3 seconds were worth it. Next up, let's talk about some bad geometry. Here is a seemingly innocent model from ZBrush. I'll go ahead and apply a retopology modifier. Did you notice that it took a bit of time? With only 83k tries, it really shouldn't take that long. Let's try computing with the default settings. It seems like the processing is also taking longer than it should. Wait, check out the message in the status bar. Remeshing element something of 1796? This model definitely doesn't look like it has 1796 elements. Here's another important tip. If you see an excessive number of elements in the message, it likely means the geometry has issues. The element mentioned in the message isn't the same as the element in editable poly or mesh. So the numbers can differ, but not by that much. After almost 6 minutes, it finished, and the message said, "Calculation failed for 1793 out of 1796. Look at all these triangles around the seams. This is when we need the mesh cleaner modifier. Apply a mesh cleaner modifier and press detect problems. It found 1792 non-manifold faces. Check the checkbox and press repair selected. Now, let's try the retopology modifier again. This time, it was added in a split second, as it should be. Let's compute. The compute time for this was 8 seconds, which is more expected. Now all looks good. But the message says it still failed for 4 elements. Please don't ignore what Max says. Add an edit poly modifier, hide all visible elements, and you'll see a few random polygons. Those are the failed ones. If you encounter these kinds of faces, it's best to clean them up. Let's quickly check out another common geometry issue. Here's another CAD model. I'll start with the default settings. Wait, 611 elements? Let's stop. Remember, An excessive number of elements usually means the mesh has problems. Switch to Edge Sub-Object mode. See how some of the edges turned gray? Now I can see the faces are black too. Looks like inverted normals. Apply the normal modifier, check Unify Normals, and uncheck Flip Normals. Give it another shot. Looks good now. Okay, the last topic. How to preserve UV and prevent spirals. This is a sample Fusion 360 model. This model has an UV. If you want to preserve the UV, you must turn on the UV channel option to preserve the seams. The UV can't be reprojected correctly without the same seams. Let's compute. All right, that was easy, and the result looks good. Let's check some edge loops since many people have complained about the spirals. This one looks fine. But if I increase the target to 15,000, I get spirals. Here's a small trick you can do with slice modifiers. It has a refine mesh type, which draws edges along the slice plane. Then, the new refined edges are automatically selected. Then, we can use the selected edges option in the auto edge to use them as guides. Let's compute again. The spirals are gone. As you can see from this video, even though the retopology modifier doesn't have a custom guide feature yet, you can still use the various auto edge methods to control the edge flow. All right, that's it. I hope you learned a few new tricks from this tutorial. Thank you for watching, and happy modeling.